In this video tutorial, we are going to learn how to add text to our video recording in DaVinci Resolve. This is a very important tutorial because it will expose you to the different features, different text types, different animations, and how to add each one of them. This is going to be more or less like a detailed tutorial on how to add text and do all sort of animations with it, from simple to presets to even how to customize your text to have fantastic transitions within the video behavior. Okay, so to start with, all you need to do is to open your DaVinci Resolve and import a video clip. For example, I've opened mine and I've imported this very simple video clip of mine in my office, drinking a cup of tea and trying to explain something. So I'm going to put in some text that can signify what I'm doing. So if you have not, if you don't have DaVinci Resolve, you can easily go onto the website, DaVinci Resolve blackmagic.com/products and DaVinci Resolve. You have the latest version over here. It's free to download and install, and most of the features are here. Additionally, if you want to have the complete tutorial on how to use DaVinci Resolve, I'll put the link up here so you can just have it and go through it. But this is going to be in detail about how to add text. So to start with, to add your text, you can just come all the way to effects over here. And once you come to effects, you can see a bunch of effects from here, different kind of effects that you can see. The one that contains text or titles is titles over here. So you just come to titles, and then you can see different kind of titles. All you need to do is just to hover over it and you see the effect of that title. What is it and how does it come in? This is left lower third and this is the center. Okay, this is right lower third, and you can have scrolls. As you hover over it, you'll be able to see the effect of that text and what it contains. Okay, you just move around. Just these are simple text and many more. So you have different kind of text down here. You have so many of them. Let's just close the media pool so we have a better look at what we have. Okay, so we have these simple ones. Okay, these are presets that you can easily come in and you can observe how they behave. Okay, you can easily drag and drop. We even have 3D text that you can add easily to your video clip. So let's start with very basic simple text and see how we can customize it, and then later on maybe we can try some very basic presets as well. So let's try it with this simple text. You can just easily drag this basic text. You can just drag it. All you need to do to add any text is just to drag it and drop it on your clip. So you just specify what place do you want to put it, and as you hover over it with the playhead, you'll be able to see the text. Basically, okay, this is the most basic part. So once you select the text, you will be able to come over to the inspector over here, and you have the basic text properties to change. Okay, so you stay on the video properties and you have the basic title over here. So let's say we want to change this text to welcome to Epic Mentorship. So you just type your text over here, and additionally you will have the option to change all the text basic text properties, like the font family. This is Open Sans. You can change it to anyone. Let's go to Oswald. Let's check something like the Optima. I like it a lot. And then you can change the face, the font face. You can make it bold, you can make it italized, you can change or increase or decrease the size as well to any size of your choice. You can play around with the sizing. And at any given point, if you are not certain or you are not comfortable with what you have changed, you can always come to this undo button and just click on it, and it will restore back the feature to its default. Okay, or you can come to the size over here or the text by the side and just double click, and it's going to bring it back to the normal shape or the default shape that you have left it. And then you have tracking. You can include line spacing, font styles. You can put in different kind of font styles over here, font cases. You can do mix, you can do all caps, you can do lower caps, and many more. Like I said, you can still have the undo button as your friend, and you can change the positions from here. Okay, the X position, the Y and Z positions, you can change them accordingly. You can rotate the text also from here. You can rotate very easily and nice. You can easily rotate it, and you have the stroke. You can add stroke if you want. Let's say we undo this rotation and we can add stroke. Okay, the size can be anything. You can add stroke, and you can see the text is kind of popping out. You can change the color of the stroke if you want. You can change it to any color. For example, you can change to, you can move it around and change to color. Okay, you can change the color to anything. After stroke, you can select any point and it will take in as that color in the stroke. Okay, so you can increase or decrease the size of the stroke just like so. And you have the drop shadow option. You could include drop shadow also. You can drop shadow or blur some certain point, or you can increase or decrease the opacity accordingly, just like so. Okay, I want to keep it the way it was. And one thing you should pay attention to is in the drop shadow and background, you have the enable and disable buttons over here. Once I enable, I disable, I can enable as well with these very features. Okay, so you can add background if you want. You can add background, you can play around with the opacity. All this you can do with the with this very simple text. You can select everything and you basically have all the text editing features over here. And you have other settings over here if you want the transform, the cropping session. You have the dynamic zoom if you want to include dynamic zoom, and composites and speed change as well. You can change the speeds as you so wish from here. So many things to look into, but for now let's stay at the basic title and the basic text properties. And then you can come all the way over here. For example, I may want to add some animations on how the text come in and goes out. Okay, so to add animation to text, make sure you select that particular text, and then you can come all the way to video transitions. You can see there are different kind of transitions that you can add. For example, the additive dissolve, you can see the preview, you can see blur dissolve, also you can see cross dissolve, also you can see deep dissolve. There are so many of them. Okay, so many of them that you can easily drag and drop. Okay, I have this crash zoom that I usually like to put, and you can just easily drag it and drop it in your text. You can see it has just put it as the inlet. Okay, the transition to inwards, you can just see the transition very nicely. Now you can increase or decrease the transition time. Okay, you can do it manually here, or you can do it over here as well. You can change the timing over here. So once you have the transition selected, all its properties will come up here. You can increase the duration and the frame rate. You can increase or decrease accordingly. So this one now, it will be a little bit slower, just like so. It will just come in. And if you want to reduce the sizing, you can just reduce it, and now it will come in a bit faster. So let's try it. Okay, so it comes in a bit faster. So you can put in at the outlet also. This is the in point, and then we can put it also the crash zoom at the out point and put the same properties as well. And let's see how it's going to fade out from the clip. So it fades out. I think that kind of looks fine and nice. So you can do all sort of things, all sort of if you want to even add some blur, motion blur in it, you can easily add. So selecting that particular transition, you can add motion blur to it as it comes in. So let's have a preview. Okay, so you can see the motion blur. It's quite little, but it's there. Okay, so you can do all sort of things. You can add different kind of properties over here. So this is the basic transitions. Now, this is not the only effect that you can put on your text in DaVinci Resolve. And DaVinci Resolve equally have what they call the text plus. Okay, so text plus, you can find it over here, coming back to title, and then you can see text plus over here. In addition to text, this has more properties than the ordinary text, so you can easily drag and drop it within your text. Okay, and you can increase or decrease the text position. You can, this is, you may want it to start here, or you can extend to the beginning, or you want, may want it to reduce the sizing to stop at this point. You can do all that with the end functions. Okay, so down here you can have, this is text plus, just like the normal text, but this one has more properties. So you can see once you select it, you have the custom title. And let's say we select this and type something, Dr. Rashid. And you have series of more controls in addition to the one that you have in the normal text. For example, you have the very basic text editing features like the font styles and font family. You can change to any text, any font of your choice. You have the option to change to any font. You can change the coloration. You have this feature, you can change it to any color. You can just check accordingly and change it to any color of your choice. If you want to put in track line spacing, you can just change accordingly. Say okay to this. Let's say we'll keep it at this color. If you want other features as well. The tab spacing, you can change over here. You can change the position from here very, very nicely. And you have other features like the advanced controls. You can check the advanced controls over here. If you want to put in other features, you can easily put here as well. So in addition to all this, you have the layout, and you have the layout options. You can play around with the type. You can see it over here, the frame, the circles, and you have rotations. Right now you can change, rotate it on the X axis, okay, and you can rotate on the Y axis as well, and then you can rotate on the Z axis depending on how much rotation you want. And at any given point, you can always double click on the X axis to bring it back to the default position, and then the Y axis also to rotate back. You can change background also. You can add background coloration. You can change, you can put in different color and even alpha color and many more. Okay, so you can do quite a lot in the layout option. And then the transform also, you can increase, play around with the spacing, the pivots, the rotation, the share option, as well as the size. Okay, so you have the, you can increase the size on the X axis and increase the size on the Y axis as well, depending on how you want it. So this text plus kind of contain more features than the ordinary text. So you have shading, you can bring in different shades and different color, the softness, position, rotation, and many more. Okay, you have image properties, you can play around with the properties and many more settings from here. So with the text plus, you have more features and more controls. So you can easily add the transitions. You can have other transitions as well, like the brand wipe. You can easily put that or any other style that you want. For example, this fusion, you can add this to your text, not necessarily to the entire clip. So let's say we add this crosses off. You can just drag it and drop it at the beginning. Let's see, we have the cross dissolve. Okay, you can see how your text comes in, and you can do cross dissolve out as well. You can do cross dissolve out. Okay, so you can just have it, and then it does the cross dissolve out. That's kind of like nice and fantastic. So many features to add in your text, and then you can come all the way. In addition to all this and the customization that you can do, you can equally add presets. Okay, text presets. You have the text presets over here. You just come back to titles, and you can see many of them over here. So all you need to do is just to move around, and you see the effect. Okay, this particular effect they contain. So for example, let's delete this, and let's say we are adding this simple, or let's say we are adding something simple. Okay, so let's say we are adding something simple like this. We just drag this and drop on our timeline, and then we have the different features. Let's have a preview of how it's going to look like. This is presets, contain different kind of presets. So you see, contains two texts, one on the left and one on the right. Okay, contains two texts, one on the left and one on the right. So to customize this, you just select the preset, and then you can come all the way here. So sample left. So this is the left text of controls. This is the left text. So let's say epic mentorship. Okay, you can see it over here. So let's try to separate so that it looks kind of professional and nice. Epic mentorship. And then you can go down to have the other text as well. Okay, so this is the right text, the one that we have on the right side. So let's say we have this glaring ideas. Okay, so let's go back and change the color. So let's say on this one, the right text color right now is white. We can make it to be red, or we can make it to be this color, okay, blue. And then we can go back and change the left one, left text color, to maybe something like something that can pop out a little bit. Let's say we make it something like this, and maybe we can bold it a little bit. Okay, let's say okay to this, and then we can bold it a little bit so that it can stay. We can bold it. Okay, so it's now sharper. But I think I don't like this color. We can go with something like red, but it's not good as well. Okay, you're free to play around with the colorations. Maybe something dark can work better. All right. Okay, so, and then maybe I try to play around with the position. Okay, so let's say we select the text. So like we can see, the text features, the controls have been subdivided into left text controls, the right text control, the center text control, center line controls. For example, you can change the color of this line as well if you want. You can just select it and change the color to anything of your choice. Okay, instead of the normal color, the blue color they have, you can change it to any color. And then you can try to play it and see the preview for yourself. Yeah, this is it. And then it zoom out and goes out just like that. Very nicely done. So a lot of presets. The DaVinci Resolve comes with so many presets. Okay, you can have even text over shape. You can put in different kind of text. For example, you can drag this and drop. Say we delete this one, you can drag and drop, and then you have text over shape. So how many text? You have 1, 2, and 3 texts. So all you need to do is to select the control, the text, and then go back to the text features. So you have the shape, the first text. Okay, so you have the first text control. So let's say welcome. Okay, so you can move down, and then you have the second welcome to, and then we can have the third text over here. We can just type it epic mentorship. Yeah, kind of nice. And that's it. So let's have a preview. Also, you can all as well change all the other properties. See, welcome to epic mentorship. Yeah, and then it zooms out. So basically, this is how to play around with different kind of features to add different kind of controls, and you have the option to do all sort of things, all sort of properties. You can edit very easily and nice. And if you want to play around with the text, with the shape also, in this case you can change the shape properties so that different shapes, the first text, second text, can change the controls, the shape corner radius, if you want to add radius to it to look something like this, or you want to scale it up or down. And then you can do all sort of things. You can change the color, okay, over here, and many more. Okay, so you just feel free to give it a try and let's see how you can edit or put in some fantastic text to look kind of nice and professional. Welcome to epic mentorship. So ladies and gentlemen, this is the basics of how to bring in text and play around with text, add text to your clip, and then play around with it, change the different kind of features, different kind of transitions, add other effects to it, and many more. Okay, so feel free to give it a try. Thanks for watching. In order for you to keep enjoying videos like this, please remember to subscribe and hit the notification button so that you can be notified the next time I upload another video. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.